Welcome back to your Average Witch Snack Size Edition. In this bite-sized episode, Casey lets us know what's happening in the witch world and asks for some snack recommendations. And I'm inviting you to check out my Patreon for free. I'm opening up a few more slots this year and adding another tier for witches who really love crystals. From now until March 1st, you can get a free 7-day trial to my Patreon and check out all the digital content offered. And now here's Casey.
Hey y'all, this is Casey coming at y'all from my little corner of the world, and I am so thankful to be back for another snack-sized visit. Speaking of snacks, first of all, what are you snacking on as you listen to this episode? I want to know. If you're on Insta, drop it in your stories, tag me in the podcast so we can snack together. I am currently working my way through a dark chocolate medley trail mix, and it's delicious. I'm loving it. Dried cranberries, walnuts, pecans, so good. I'm trying to branch out on my snacking game though, so tell me what you're snacking on. I need new ideas. Now, I won't call my new snacks goal a resolution per se. As you may have heard, it's the Gregorian New Year, and you know everyone and their mama be talking about the New Year's resolutions this time of year. New Year, new me season. The pressure to suddenly have your shit together enough to know what you need to do to change your whole life can be nausea-inducing. But you know what? We're witches. We make up our own rules, and succumbing to societal pressure has never been our strong suit. Many of us celebrated the new year back in the fall with Samhain, or more recently with Yule. Personally, I do New Year's, type stuff around my birthday, since that is literally the start of my personal existence. And maybe because I'm an Aries and all things start with us. No matter the reason, that doesn't mean I am completely immune to the whole hubbub that is this time of year. Humans in general do tend to love fresh starts. At least that's what the fancy people on the NPR interview were saying as this year began. I heard a conversation where they reminded us not to put so much pressure on ourselves to have it all figured out, but that there is a psychological trigger in our brain we can tap into anytime we see a day as a new beginning, whether it's the start of the year, the month, the week, or even the birthday of one particular Aries in March, Mariah Carey. We may be birthday twins. And I do have to admit, as 2022 came to a close, I felt a huge weight lift as I embraced the fresh start that 2023 offered. The point is, we can decide when to take that fresh start and trigger that clean slate reaction in our brain when the timing suits us best. Witch or no. While I may not be setting new resolutions this time of year, I am taking cues from the natural cycles around me, aka winter in my corner of the world, and I'm taking this time to reflect on the goals I set for myself over the past season, wrapping those up and releasing myself from any goal gone by the wayside because, maybe something better took its place. And finally, preparing myself for the coming season of sowing new growth. Witchy stuff. Usually that means I spend winter reading the last of the books in my book stack and clearing up my project basket. Since this past year was so wrapped up in preparing myself for my big Anahatis trip, as well as recovering from major bipolar cycles in my life, I was beginning to beat myself up as 2022 came to a close before I reminded myself how unnecessary that was. The Gregorian calendar got nothing on me. I am the witch. I make the decisions myself. Thank you very much. So now that I can take that pressure off myself, I am enjoying wrapping up the books I began reading over the past year. I may have accidentally won a new one that I started, but I couldn't help it. I'm also enjoying working my way through my mending pile that accumulated over the end of fall and the start of winter. I'm working my way down to those favorite overalls of mine, the leopard print ones I will forever be stitching back together as long as we live. I'm coming back for you, baby. I'm also settling into new routines that are the result of the previous year's work, including my own work to return to a healthier mental state. It's been a long road, but worth every step and worth the work it takes to keep my progress. Thankfully, I have amazing friends supporting me, and one of them happened to need to rehome a couple of planners that are perfect for me to use this time of year or this year. I'm so very grateful to her and everyone else I've made friends with in recent years. I didn't think I could make friends anymore until I healed that part of me and actually gave friendship a chance again. It was worth it. While I am enjoying this period of rest, I'm also excitedly filling out my planners with events and places I hope to see this year or in coming years. While I know I won't make it this year, the Tucson Gem Show is in there, so I can keep an eye out for all the folks posting about their own visits to the sparkling Mecca out in Kim's corner of the world. It takes place across 48 different locations across the city of Tucson from January 28th to February 12th. And according to Kim and the Visit Tucson website, you don't want to miss this. The first major event I'm working towards is going to be at the North Texas Irish Festival, taking place this year over the first weekend of March in Dallas, Texas. This year, I will be a manager working in the culinary building all weekend long. You know, the place with the taste testing. So I'd love if some local witches stop by for a visit. The festival celebrates the large Irish diaspora in Texas and pretty much all those who love Ireland, as well as inviting out the Scottish clans for a good old-fashioned Celtic reunion. There's music and dancing on a dozen stages around the park, lots of art and vendors, and of course, plenty of food and drink to sustain you through the day of Irish merriment. My favorite stage is in the building I work in and hosts the traditional acoustic Irish music that makes my heart sing and my soul cry for a place I've never been. Ducking into that room throughout the day offers sanctuary from the noise and the shuffle of the crowd whenever I start to feel overstimulated by it all. I definitely recommend stopping by if you just need a little breather from everything. This event is something that's helped me start healing the parts of me that didn't feel Irish enough to even claim my own ancestry. That feeling made it impossible for me to feel connected to my own ancestors, and as a witch, that made me feel so disconnected from my own roots. Honestly, I never felt enough of anything to belong anywhere until I decided no one gets to deny me my heritage, no matter how mixed. I claimed my place there when a friend invited me to join the volunteer team. Even though you really don't have to have any Irish heritage to volunteer for or even enjoy the event, but for me, that's what it signified because of my own childhood wounds. That newfound determination was immediately tested with new wounds that came when I made a celebratory social media post about the event. And someone asked me if I was a little too Mexican to be Irish. I felt like that little kid I went there to heal. I was hurt, but my friends over in the Witch Bitch Amateur Hour group lifted my chin up and told me I absolutely belonged. I almost quit then, but I'm so glad I didn't because 3 years later, here I am set to step into a whole new role with so much more responsibility this year, and I feel like I really do belong. Not just there, but in my own ancestry work. I don't feel like such an imposter anymore because I've embraced so many more parts of me that I felt were denied, that I denied myself. I can't wait to be back there, setting up vendor spaces in those old World's Fair era buildings there in Fair Park. And if I'm really lucky, I'll get a chance to break away for a bit and explore the insides of the building again. That's one of my favorite parts and perks about being a volunteer. If I do, you can be sure I'll tell you all about it over on my channel and other socials, which you can find linked in the description. If you have any events you think I should be attending or shouting out, you can email me at welcome to Casey's Corner at hotmail.com. Be sure to check out my page and shop over at ko-fi.com/Casey's Corner. That's ko-fi.com/KACIESCORNER. Casey's Corner, where I'll soon be adding exclusive content for my members there. That Ko-fi there, it funds my unboxing videos and my major event travels, which is how I will get back to Anahatas if the stars aligned. So thank you so much to everyone who's already become a member over there so far and who's purchased from my shop as I learn how to use that page. There is a bit of a learning curve. I'm getting there. But thank you guys so much. Y'all are my OGs. I love y'all. Thank you again to Kim for having me back for another snack-sized visit from my little corner of the world. Don't forget to tag us in your stories and tell me what you're snacking on this episode, by the by. Kim, what are you snacking on? I need new ideas for things to try. I want to know. Share the good foods. Recommend something. You too. Everybody, tag me in your stories. Recommend the foods. Thank you so much. And thank you so much for listening. Y'all have a great day. I'll see y'all next month. Love y'all. Bye.
I invited some of my patrons on to talk about what they personally get out of my Patreon. It wasn't rehearsed. None of us, including me, knew what we were going to say. I thought of doing it, asked them on Marco, and about 15 minutes later, well, you'll hear it when you listen to the rest of this episode. They share what their favorite box was and why, list a few perks I actually forget about sometimes, and I think the recording really shows how we have become a pretty tightly knit little community over the Marco Polo app. So if you're looking for a spell box once a month, maybe some intention-filled jewelry made by a witch, that witch being me, or you just want podcast bonuses, videos, and a family through your phone, give my Patreon a look over at patreon.com/CleverKim'sCurios. Welcome, everyone.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Okay, so in the order that you came in, introduce the person after you, before you.
Okay. This will be a fun game.
Who wants to go
Kim,
first?
Kim, I think you go first. You introduce Kim, the next person.
Hey, great.
Who
thanks.
Was here first?
It's my awesome idea. Well, first we have Andrea, who is actually kind of a new patron, and she does gardening, and I just interrupted her. Hi, welcome.
Hi, I'm Andrea. I do gardening, and I'm going to introduce Casey, who has snakes.
Hi, I'm Casey, and after me came in Sarah. Yes, Sarah, the pottery gal from Flora and Function.
Hi, I'm Sarah. I do pottery. I do witchy crafts. It's a great time. Janie is also a wonderful crafter and does some pretty amazing crochet and knitting and t-shirts and all sorts of fun stuff. So Janie.
Hi, I'm Janie. And yes, I'm from Fantasy Core Creations and I do a little bit of everything. And all done with intention. And I'm going to introduce Kim, who is the leader of our pack.
That is not accurate.
Snack pack, leader of the snack pack.
Yeah, I was singing it to Andrew.
I am the vanilla and chocolate swirl hunt's cup. What are you?
Are we going in the same order again?
You can do it at whatever order you want. Talk over one another. I don't care.
Great.
It'll make editing so fun.
I'm dried cranberries.
I love dried cranberries.
I'm eating a dark chocolate medley that has dried cranberries, and I'm the dark chocolate part.
Oh no! What am I? I have no. I'm the spicy part in your spicy chocolate.
I like
and I am
chocolate.
Trail mix because I'm a little sweet and a little salty.
And you have so much to offer, Janie.
Yes, yes, yes. Something for everyone.
Okay, so the reason we are all having this little snack pack party is because I have new availability on my Patreon. So I am here with my patrons so they can tell you why you should join.
Woo!
Yay!
That was super.
I have a reason, a smart one.
Ooh, what is it?
It's because without being part of the Patreon, you won't get to know all of us crazy.
That's very true.
That is true. Because y'all are so great. I love you all so much.
We love you.
We love you too.
Yay! It's a love party.
Oh, the snack love.
Yeah, and without you guys, I wouldn't be able to cook anything for the week because I wouldn't have the inspiration without you.
None of us knew each other before this.
Yeah, none of us did. And now they're my family.
Other than stalking each other on social media. Andrea,
I'm with you. Just been sneaking around for a long time, but now you know me from the time I get up with a cowlick in my hair to the time I go to bed and my hair's wet again from the shower.
That's so true. We get to see each other through like the whole day, and like honestly, y'all are the people. Like Kim's Patreon group are the people that I talk to most often through Marco Polo, and it's wonderful because we get to, you know, hang out with each other and help out when we're struggling, and also just, you know, yell things and sing things at each other because it's fun.
That's exactly and there's, it.
It's so much more than just like witchy stuff. We talk about literally everything. We talk about kid issues. We talk about salad life tossing. Issues. We talk about food.
Meal planning for the week. Please help.
We pull tarot in the morning for each other. Or
Oh, yeah. I don't do that because I'm bad at it, but I graciously accept it from everyone else.
Occasionally.
You know what I do? I pull a card and then I say, here's a card. Go ahead and tell yourself what it means.
We share books.
Oh, yeah. That's good too.
Yeah.
Lots of books. Goodness, what else do we
share? Shows. We talk about shows a lot.
Oh, yeah. This show sucks. We haven't been in This Show Sucks for a while.
Oh, my gosh. I needed that the other day, though. This Show Sucks. Yeah. That group, you guys got me through. That show. Oh, my God. I was dying. And I was like, I need support. This show sucks. You guys have to suffer through this with me. So I had like two videos I recorded because I was like, if no one else will believe how bad this is, I have to drop it in there at least.
We also share like, oh my gosh, this intro makes me think of people like when the Great British Bake Show had their their Star Wars intro, and I was like, Casey, this is for you.
Oh my gosh, yes. Yes, the emotional support reels that I get from you guys, like, thank you so much. Just especially
I hope you're not going to get annoyed all the with happy how many dog I ones. Sent you.
No. Oh no. I that was a rough week, and just seeing just all the little happy dog memes you would send me and would make me smile. And thank you so much. You got me through. Like,
hey, I hear someone needs support memes and I'm like, I got you.
Well, and just the support is incredible. Like when I'm having a really terrible day or like have just been like, I can't deal with this anymore. Y'all will always come in and just like give me advice or just listen to me rant or make an entire reel of like, making me look really awesome, Casey. Thank you.
You are really awesome. You are all really awesome.
Yay.
This is going to make me cry.
Came in for chaos recording. Ended with making Kim cry.
I'm throwing bread at you.
Chucking rolls.
Stay from you. Throw muffins. Throw croissants.
Also, you guys have made your own little subgroups and I'm not even in. In the D&D group.
Yeah, we have a D&D group. We have a crafting group.
I'm not even in these.
Yeah, we have a We have a Claire's group where we meet and practice our Claire's exercises to enhance our psychic
ability. One's been really fun. Yeah.
It's been very surprising. I actually don't completely suck at
Same.
That.
Woo-hoo! Shocker.
Yay!
Although, Kimothy, guess
One
what?
Piece, bread and grease?
Chicken butt.
Yes. Exactly. No, the only way that I can, like, figure out what I'm feeling is with my pendulum.
Hey, see?
And then I get feelings of, like, I feel like it's a spoon. I don't know why I'm feeling spoon. And Andrea gets all excited and goes, oh my God, it's a spoon!
That is cool. You guys
Andrea
haven't been talking. I'm not in the group anymore because I can't deal with it right now because it's a gem show. But that is freaking cool.
I think once you get through gem show and some other people are kind of dealing with some stuff too, we'll throw it back out there and see who wants to come back in. Like, I know Casey's been so busy too. Yeah. So hopefully we can get you guys in it because it's been a lot of fun.
Yeah, I wanted to do it, but I also know, like, I just was not in the headspace for that yet and was not going to subject anybody to my headspace, like, in that way. Like, I'm not going to purposely project accidentally whatever's going on in there. Like, when y'all were getting that going, I was like, oh no, this is a bad time for me. I'm going to get myself together and then I'll try and, you know, build psychic links on purpose.
But this group is perfect when you are in a bad headspace because you come in and you're like, oh my God, I'm having such a terrible time. And everybody's like, let's talk about it. Let's figure out why. What can we do to
Or just,
it?
That's okay.
Yes. Oh, okay.
Kind of like the other day when you all were like, get up and go shower. And I said, okay.
We also have a lot of really challenging conversations too that I just don't feel like are received the same way outside of our group. Like, we're very open-minded and it's received well if someone gives you, like, you know, a different way of thinking or some criticism on the way you're thinking and challenges you to think outside the box, which is really nice. It's very comforting.
Yeah, I feel like we can trust one another to criticize, because I don't do that anymore very much. I don't think. If I do, fucking tell me I'm a dumbass. But I don't think I do. But in this group, I'm more likely if I think it's helpful. I don't think critique for no reason is helpful. But if I think it might help somebody, then I would. By the way, there's a dog in one of our backgrounds. So
it's not mine.
It's fine.
Not a
it's
wild
not
bull.
Me going full goblin mode. It's an actual dog.
We haven't even talked about the awesome, like, so boxes.
I was getting to that. I was gonna say, what
Open
about the actual boxes?
The actual
I send
thing.
You
top of the community.
Because those are awesome, and like I get them quarterly and it's so fun. Like, there's so much anticipation and then, like, finally getting the box and being like, oh my gosh. And there's so many goodies and it's just a great way. Cause the reason that I originally started was to just, like, give me something to kind of get me out of my comfort zone and doing something a little bit different to, like, push my craft and push what I was trying to do, and the boxes helped with that. And then I met everybody and got on Marco Polo, and here we are.
Bonus.
Snack fam.
Yeah. So I started kind of for the same reason. I'm very new to the craft. I wanted to try little bits of things to see what my niche was. pendulum. but I love getting, first of all of the incense
so good.
That smells
oh my gosh.
So good. I don't have to buy incense anymore because Kim sends it all. And then I don't even remember what it's called, but like the plus tier where I get a little piece of jewelry or something every month, and I love the necklaces that she makes. They're so beautiful, and I wear them all the time. Yeah, that's my favorite part.
Oh, I love. I'm on the plus tier, so I get to every so often like actually work with Kim, like, so I mean from a distance, and but at least like kind of like craft, like, you know, say like kind of what, either, you know, sometimes she'll ask us like you know what we're interested in, like kind of what we're working on, or if we want to, like, we'll get to choose like between different stones or something, and just different aspects of the piece that, like, it's, oh, I feel like one of those fancy people getting to like craft my jewelry pieces with the artisan. It's awesome. I definitely love the plus fancy tier.
Yeah, y'all get
and the snacks. Oh my gosh, snacks.
Yes.
Each month.
I'm a Taurus.
Snacks I wouldn't get to try. Like, she's pushed me to try new things. I may not always like them, but I'm trying them.
Yay for trying them, Casey.
Yes.
I think one of the fun parts about the box is, you know, I've had a couple other subscriptions in the past, but like, I didn't have someone to like share the experience with. So I open my box. I'm excited to share my excitement with Kim, but then all of us kind of pop on at different times after everybody's gotten their box and displays whatever it is that we were working on from that box, and kind of like shares the experience or the moment for the most part. And I think that's fun. Like, you don't have that option because the other boxes don't come with a community, you know, like here.
Yeah. Yeah. I love that, seeing the different ways we can each interpret like the same tools, the same like box, but like we all, you know, put our own spin on it, and I like just getting to see that with the community here.
Yay.
Oh yeah, because I don't generally give you, this is exactly how you do it.
No, right,
you'll, I don't give us, think, like, I do that, this is how, no, I do
you'll
it
give
and
us
this
like
is
like a general outline.
Yeah,
but I love that we've got like freedom to play with it and adapt
and
it to
I get to have a little bit of a behind the scenes experience with the box. I have gotten to collab with Kim on a couple of different things, and it is so much fun working with you, working with her, and being excited to see how everybody reacts to the things that I get to make and put a little bit of my own thing on. So that is really fun too.
And now we got coloring pages.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah. Oh my god, I love my coloring page.
Dad, thank you, Janie, for pointing it out that you can do those just by downloading them onto your little tablet, and you don't have to have a printer to print them out. I don't know why I didn't think of that on my own. Thank you, Janie, for being a genius.
And then you can color the same coloring page like 50 different
ways. I was just super excited and printed it right away and like colored it so fast and was so excited. Because I'm an artist who likes to be told, here are the lines that you get to color in.
And the coloring pages are actually from Ruth, who is somebody that some of us met at Anahata's Purpose. All of us this year will meet her at Anahata's Purpose. And she's a fellow witch. And these are just for Clever Kim's Curios patrons.
Thank you, Ruth.
And the picture is beautiful. It's so detailed. And there's like pictures hanging on the wall in the picture. Oh, I love it.
I love that style so much. It, I just love it so much. It reminds me of some childhood books I love. Mm-hmm. It's just so comforting, cozy, and oh, yeah. And I just love Ruth.
I can't wait to see the next one.
Yeah.
I know.
And I have no idea what she's sending. She just said it's going to be a glimpse into the life of your average witch, so who knows?
That's
nice.
That's awesome.
Yay.
I love that.
Yeah, she has complete freedom
artistic
over what
licensing.
She does. I couldn't remember words. Yes, that.
I want to see one where it's a witch just like in leggings and a hoodie, just, you know,
shopping.
Yes.
Yes. I gotta laying go to the grocery store.
Laying in her bed with her curtains just barely open and her hair all awry and like makeup from yesterday running down the face.
Yes.
That's more realistic.
So a glimpse up at the Marco group.
The we are all at the grocery store a lot, though.
The opposite of aesthetic.
Yes. But that, but beautifully aesthetic.
Yes.
And, because... and most of us with animals in our laps.
Yeah.
Or like,
yeah,
stepping
I have like
on our face.
14 cats now, all of them in the picture.
Overachiever. You went beyond the normal 13 cats for a witch and went straight to 14.
So, I'm a crazy person.
It would be Kim's face and then a bunch of cats.
You see my glasses. My glasses and my hair.
Oh my God.
Where's Timothy?
Under the pile of cats.
Oh my God. Yeah. Oh my God. Like the green men are, you know, with instead
with
of all
the leaves.
Oh my gosh.
Yes. And then keeping out. Yes.
Casey's got all the dog hair from the grooming.
Just a cloud of it.
Yeah.
It's just groomer glitter.
Yes.
Well, and then you'd have to have Andrea in all the wonderful, I don't want to say produce, but that's the only word I can think of right now. Produce that she's grown.
Mm-hmm. Oh, pretty vegetation.
Like, I was there. Ridiculous amount of like oranges and just baskets and baskets.
And tomatoes.
The size of her face.
Yes.
And Janie would be like all with the yarn all around and like all the different things.
Yeah. And her dogs.
Yeah, and her dogs.
Fairy mode.
So you just see the dog noses and all the yarn and then Janie's little face in the middle.
Or just my hair.
So it looks little pointy ears. Little fairy
and
crown.
Sarah and with all of her little tumblers and her butterbells, which, oh my God, I love my butterbell. And her candle holder. Oh!
And just like covered in clay.
Yeah, yes. With the clay water splashed everywhere.
Yes.
Okay, so for the last thing, I would like you to tell me what your favorite box has been.
Ooh.
Mm. Oh, I'll go first because I haven't had very many.
Okay.
But, and it's easier for me to pick from. I really liked the most recent one that had to do with like, you know, bringing sunshine into this kind of stagnant time of the year where it's not the holiday season, but it's not spring yet. I ended up taking some of my items after doing the ritual and made like solar tea, including them, and then like was able to drink the tea and have that kind of light and rejuvenation the rest of the week. And it's just like been super joyous and happy.
That's so cool.
I really like this past month, but I think my favorite, just because I was thinking about this. And I feel like it came at the perfect time, was the box with the crystal grid in it, because I love me some crystals, and I kept seeing them everywhere, and I was like, I don't know how to use this. And guess what? A crystal grid and instructions came in the box.
Delivered right to your door.
And then we get to
learn. I didn't even have to ask for it.
Convenient. That is nice. How often like we'll just things will sync up with like what we need, and it's just mm-hmm. like yes, it's like we're a bunch of witches.
What?
I mean, it's kind of like that.
It's exactly like
I have to say my favorite box, because I'm eyeballing it right now. It's that one with the bell and the light sun catcher crystal at the bottom, because that is the gift that just keeps on giving. I have it hanging in my window. That's one. So I'm like, just the rainbows that it shines all over the place. It just makes me so happy all the time.
I love that.
And
one
I like bells.
Because it does not catch any sun.
No.
I gotta have it in the right spot. I have it in a pair. Oh, I love where I have it. Cause yeah, just like this morning, I just had posted on the Instagrams cause I got surprised with a surprise rainbow. And I'm like, it throws rainbows in all kinds of directions. That surprise means sneak up on me.
Casey, I'm so glad you said that one, because I was tied between that one and the community box for my favorite. So now I get to talk about the community box. Because Because I love that one. And the little candle that came in it, I like only burn a tiny bit at a time, but I use it whenever I'm doing like the card pulls for us. And I was using it during like our intuition practice. And it's so great because I can light it and I immediately feel connected. And that's really awesome. And then all the other things.
My heart.
Right?
That's how I feel. I used the necklace from that one. That's what I wanted. That's when I use the necklace from that one for all those occasions and stuff. Like when, because, yep, same. I love the community one.
I'm wearing that one's necklace.
I just used the community candle too for our reset after Mercury retrograde.
Oh, yay.
Oh, that's awesome.
Oh, that's really cool because I just took a nap.
That'll do it.
Janie's our napper.
Resident napper.
Professional napper. She naps
professionally. There was also, there was like a lot of, a lot of people in the Marco also loved the simmer pot that dehydrated all that stuff, Kim. Like that was fun hearing how people were using those over the holidays too.
Yes, that was perfect for my Yule time because I wasn't feeling it. I was just kind of stressed out about Christmas and not really feeling the spiritual side of it like I wanted to. And I put that simmer pot on and it was kind of a very grounding thing for me because I was like, okay, let me get ready for this. The sun's coming back. Christmas should not be my focus right now. And it was really nice. I really liked that.
Yay.
Thank you.
Thank you. I love you guys.
Love you too.
Love you. Love you.
Thank you for bringing us all together.
Yeah, for real.
Thank you for wanting to do that.
And the, you know, fifth or sixth or seventh best thing about her boxes, I've lost count. When you are part of the Hive group, then when we go to Anahatas, we have a whole Hive house, and it's like a slumber party all weekend. It's the best thing.
And you've already like gotten to get to know the people some. So for us who are, you know, maybe a little quiet or
it's
awkward.
It's like 67% less scary.
Oh my gosh, so much less scary. Because you already
know
someone.
Very specific percentage.
Yeah.
Math.
We are great at math in this group.
I only said some numbers.
But data shows it is exactly 67% less scary.
What's the numerology on that?
I don't know. That involves numbers.
Me either.
I just made up
some
words.
We're now recruiting numerology witches. Please join Patreon.
Right? Yeah, fill in the gaps here. We've got some gaps to fill in. We'd appreciate you joining
us.
Yes, educating us on the numbers.
Tell me what these numbers mean.
Who else should we page?
Right. Everyone, come join the Patreon.
Yeah, we got a couple farm witches.
Come join us and tell us about you. Tell us what kind of witch you are.
Right.
Yes.
Sarah is now in charge of my marketing.
Hi. You're welcome. Join your average witch. Tell us what kind of witch you are. Branding.
Oh my god. Because I didn't think of it. That's going to be for Sarah's Patreon.
Yes. Yeah. Yes. That I'm going to look at today, maybe.
I was gonna say, going to say, when is that coming out, Sarah?
When I figure out how it all works.
Just like this. You're doing it now, girl.
Right now. Okay.
Yeah. You also get some mediocre coaching on how to do Patreon from me.
Yay! Somebody really, ask questions.
Between all of us, like just in all of our different ventures, it's just so helpful to have each other to like. Because I don't know, between between the group of us, somebody has some sort of answer to something, to all of our whole variety of questions that has helped, like, all of us really kind of like grow just our different ventures, whether it's like our small businesses or whatever, or just like getting our lives together.
Even if the answer is, I don't know, but I know somebody who does.
Mm-hmm. Right. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Networking.
Yeah. But that goes for kind. Like tops and things too. Like if, mm-hmm. if we're looking for any kind of product item thingy majiggy, we can ask, like, and somebody knows. Like
Choco
knows.
Gel, Little Debbie Choco Gel.
Right.
And Tapatio Doritos.
We have the nation covered in snacks. If you can't find it, we will send it.
We have somebody somewhere who can find it.
Totally. Not guaranteed.
Not guaranteed at all.
Nope.
If you're a witch in the Gulf Coast region, please, 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 please join. I need somebody here.
At the very least, go make friends with Jamie.
Right? Yeah.
I will feed you.
She makes good food.
Well, thank y'all. Thank y'all so much for doing this and for this was so fun. We should do this more often.
We'll light a candle for your editing.
Yeah.
See? People will light candles when you're doing ridiculous things.
Yes.
Yeah, like when you have crazy weekends where you work more hours than there are hours in that weekend.
Yeah.
Some people will light you a coffee candle and then leave it burning all day and all night. And
when you're constantly double booking all the dogs.
Yeah, those.
We will light you a candle.
Yes.
We'll light things on fire for you.
Yes.
Yes. Like lighting things on fire.
Come on, Patreons, light our fires. Yeah.
Yeah.
Thanks, everybody.
Thank you.
Thank you,
Cam. See you on Marco.
Okay, bye.
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 If you want to try before you buy, I'm currently offering a free 7-day trial for the $5 tier. This gives you access to the monthly spells, podcast bonuses, videos, and more, including the Marco Polo family. Thanks again to Andrea, Casey, Sarah, and Janie for going along with my impulsivity and recording that bit 15 minutes after I thought of it. And as I repeatedly said, I love you all. Just a tiny bit of housekeeping if you've listened this far, I have exciting news. In February, after I'm finished buying the patron gifts for the year at the Gem Show, I'll be putting out an episode every week. I also have a few more ad slots open in the full-length episodes, so shoot me an email at youraveragewitchpodcast@gmail.com if you want to advertise with Your Average Witch. Thanks for listening. Catch the next episode on February 7th when I interview Chris Delina, the witchy historian.